Hello guys, welcome to my channel Maths Pursuit. Today we are going to look into exercise 5.1 question 1 bit 3 from chapter 5 called arithmetic progression. So let's see what exactly we have in question number 1 bit 3. Now moving on to the question, it is given like, in which of the following situations does the list of numbers involved make an arithmetic progression and why? And bit 3 is the cost of digging a well. After every meter of digging, when it costs rupees 150 for the first meter and rises by rupees 50 for each subsequent meter. Now let us see how we can solve this question. Coming to the solution, let us first note down the questions and analyze it so that it would be easy for us to understand and solve the question accordingly. Now moving on to the question, it is given like the cost of digging a well after every meter of digging. When it costs rupees 150 for the first meter and rises by rupees 50 for each subsequent meter. So that means what we could understand from this question is it costs 150 rupees for the first meter. After digging first meter, the person who is asking the persons to dig is need to pay 150 rupees, and then the cost rises by 150 for each meter of subsequent digging. That means for the first 1 meter the cost is rupees 150, then after that the cost will be 150 plus 50, and subsequently it will keep on rising by 50 rupees. So let us put down and start our answer. Like, after 1 meter digging, cost is rupees 150. After 2 meters digging, cost is rupees 150 plus rupees 50 because it is increasing by rupees 50, that is equal to rupees 200. After 3 meters digging, cost is rupees 150 plus rupees 50 for the 2 meters digging, and then rupees 50 for this 3 meters. So altogether it is coming rupees 250. After 4 meters digging, cost is rupees 150 plus rupees 50 for the 2 meters level plus rupees 50 for the 3 meters level, and then rupees 50 for this 4 meter level. So altogether we are getting rupees 300. Now guys, we got these figures. Like, after 1 meter, rupees 150. After 2 meter we got rupees 200, after 3 meters we got rupees 250, and after 4 meters we got rupees 300. Now let us put this data in a tabular form. As usual, we are always putting the data in a tabular form so that it will be easy for us to solve this question. Now we have created a 3 column table with 3 rows, naming first term, second term, third term, fourth term, and putting 150 under first term, 200 under second term, 250 under third term, 300 under fourth term, and naming first term as A1, second term as A2, third term as A3, fourth term as A4. Just guys, we are naming this one as A1, A2, A3, A4 so that it would be easy for us to calculate. Now let us find out the common difference. Guys, we very well know that we need to find out the common difference so that we can understand whether the given number series or the generated number series is forming an arithmetic progression or not. So A4 minus A3 is equal to 300 minus 250, that is equal to 50. A4 minus A3, that means fourth term minus third term. Now moving to the next, like A3 minus A2, third term minus second term is equal to 250 minus 200, that is equal to 50. Second term minus first term, that is A2 minus A1, that is equal to 200 minus 150, that is equal to 50. Guys, we could see that we are getting a common difference of 50 among the consecutive numbers. So guys, we could understand that looking at the common difference, that means it is forming an arithmetic progression. Therefore we can say that as the common difference D is equal to 150 among the consecutive numbers, hence this list forms an arithmetic progression. So the increasing cost of digging each meter by rupees 50 after the first meter forms an arithmetic progression. Hope guys you understood this calculation. If you have any questions or concerns, kindly write to me in the comment section of this video. Definitely I will get back to you once I see your comments. If you guys really like my videos, kindly subscribe and let your friends know. Thank you. Bye.